Big news, the SQL client is moving to NuGet. This is going to help you keep pace with new features, regardless of if you're on .NET Framework or .NET Core. Check this out on .NET. Hello, and welcome to another episode of on.NET. I'm your host, Jeremy Lickness, and today I'm with Vicky Harp. And we're going to talk about some changes that are coming to the SQL client for .NET. But before we jump into that, Vicky, why don't you tell us a little bit about who you are and what you do with Microsoft?
Sure. So I'm Vicky Harp. I'm the PM lead for the SQL Server Tools Group. And so we're the group responsible for pretty much the entire stack of experiences from driver up to the graphical interfaces in the portal. That includes the drivers, the programmability interfaces, the command line tools, the GUI tools like SQL Projects in Visual Studio, SSMS, Azure Data Studio, and so really the whole lot of it.
That's a lot. So if I'm a developer on .NET, I've probably touched SQL Server. And what you're saying is if I touch SQL Server, I've probably touched the tools that you're working with.
Yes, absolutely. Millions of people, in fact.
So. Amazing. So I understand there's some changes coming through. We're obviously shifting in the .NET arena. We've got .NET Framework. We've got .NET Core. Now it sounds like when we're looking at the SQL client that was always part of the core system, there's some changes coming down for that. What are the changes, and why would I even care as a .NET developer?
Yeah, so just kind of definitionally, most people who are using .NET who are interfacing with SQL Server, they're using the SQL client driver, and that's in system.data.sqlclient. Now, either they're using that directly and using data readers, et cetera, or they're using something like an ORM or a framework, which is in turn using that SQL client driver.
Okay.
That has always been the premier interface and assembly for communicating with SQL Server. SQL Server goes back 30 years. It's been here as long as .NET has been here, and it's always been where we put our features first and where you try them first, and then they, from there, fan out to the other drivers and languages. And so we have a really rich ecosystem of that, but it has some limitations in as .NET is changing and as the speed of development is changing. So for one thing, we have system.data.sqlclient in full framework is part of full framework, and so whenever there are updates to it, it comes through updates to the framework.
Okay.
And then the SQL client in .NET Core is a separate version of the SQL client, has a somewhat different set of functionality. So there are some features that are not present in .NET Core that are available in full framework. In addition to that, SQL Server itself is shipping more frequently and is itself now able to run on Linux and on Docker containers. And
right.
So we've got a changing environment where we are wanting to be able to ship more quickly.
Okay.
So to that end, we now have a NuGet package called Microsoft.Data.SqlClient, which has all of the client functionality that was in System.Data.SqlClient, but it's in a package that you can consume on your own and which can ship independently of the framework.
Now, this package that I can consume on my own, is this a different set of APIs or a different approach to using the client, or is it intended to be sort of a swap out, if you will?
It's very much intended to be a swap out. There's intentionality even in the name of it. It's a one-word change from system.data.sqlclient to microsoft.data.sqlclient, and otherwise all of the object references, all of the assemblies are the same. And so you should be able to just change your using statements and any of your qualified references, and it would take effect immediately.
Okay, that's awesome. And then if I do that, I'm able to take advantage of the same features now in .NET Core that were different, you're saying, before, right?
To a certain extent. So there's still some places where we're needing to build up that that difference, but we are, even in the preview version, shipping some new features compared to what was available in system.data.sqlclient. So for example, always encrypted has been a feature in SQL Server for a number of years. It's been available in full framework. It is now in the preview package of microsoft.data.sqlclient available for .NET Core. And then we're also shipping support for data classification and UTF-8 support, which are highly requested features related to SQL Server 2019. So the notion is that going forward, we'll be shipping new features of SQL Server that have a driver or assembly level consideration in the NuGet package in microsoft.data.sqlclient, whereas the traditional system.data.sqlclient will be maintained because there are millions of users of it who may not need that new function yet, but it'll be available for them when they're ready.
Okay. So if I'm fine where I'm at, I can stay. But it's a very low pain point as far as the migration. That's the intention because it's just a namespace change. And then once I do that, I should be able to take advantage of more feature changes as they come out. And I get that advantage if I'm doing a .NET Core app that everything ships together. I'm not depending on what framework is installed or what version on my target machine.
Correct. So you're not having to necessarily control for all of those things. You can have kind of a known state whenever you build it, and it's going to be the same whenever you deploy it.
And that's a package that's available today that I can get as a preview?
Yes, so it's available. We have it on the NuGet gallery, and it's also available on GitHub. And so that it's in preview now, and it'll be going to GA in pretty short order.
Okay, great. Now, I understand you have some examples that you can share about using the new client.
Yes, absolutely. So just real quick, I'll show you. This is the NuGet location, or the GitHub location. So it's at .NET SQL Client. You can give that a search. As of the time of this filming, we don't have all of the source code moved over to it yet, but that should be coming really in a matter of days or weeks.
Okay.
And so this has our release notes. If you want to read a little bit more about it or have something that you want to share with people outside of this video, we have a blog post here on the .NET blog. If you look up introducing the new Microsoft Data SQL Client, it has some of the same things that we've already discussed about the rationale and what the roadmap is going forward.
Okay.
So what I've got here in terms of a demo is a WPF app, and it's just the simplest little app. Basically, this is a little animal services app where you can, when they pick up a dog and they've got just the name, you know, for some reason they don't have their actual license on there, they can look up that dog name and see if there is a dog that has a license with that name, and then see if the breed and the color matches so that they have a notion of who they might call, given that they don't know for sure who this belongs to. So this is just a little sample app.
Okay.
And so the way that this works is we have this little button that we can search, and we have a SQL connection. It'll call a search, and then down here in the search area, you can see it's creating a parameter, passing in the name, and then basically searching and filling the grid with any of the dogs that have that name.
Okay.
Relatively straightforward little data app. So I'm going to run this. I'll also point out that this is a WPF app, and here's the full framework version, and down here I have the .NET Core version of the same application. So I'm going to run the full framework version. And start a new instance here. Give it a moment.
You know the trick, right? You move the mouse clockwise.
Oh, yes, and it makes it go faster.
Speeds it up, makes the hamsters run faster.
Exactly.
And there we go.
So let's just look up Hunter and see how many dogs we have named Hunter. So we've got 58, and you can see we've got the license type, the breed, and let's say we said, okay, we found a little Shih Tzu in black, and then we go over here and take a look, and this is the owner zip. I'm using just the zip code for this demo, but you would imagine it would be all of the owner's contact information.
Okay.
And you see that works perfectly well. Now, if I go down here in the .NET Core version, we're going to see a little bit of a different response here. So this is kind of a case where we're assuming that someone is trying to convert to .NET Core for the first time. And so they've run into this, and so the first time they run it, they get it all set up. We run Hunter, and we're going to get search here. You get error, keyword not supported, column encryption setting.
Okay.
So what does that mean? So if I take a look over at the table, we can see that that owner zip that I was referring to earlier is actually encrypted. So it's encrypted with column encryption here, and it's using actually a key that I have locally on my machine. So this is something that you were able to handle transparently through a feature called Always Encrypted, and that was being handled in the full framework, and it wasn't being handled in .NET.
Okay, right.
If I go over here and change the, see this column encryption setting enabled, that's enabling that feature. So if I change connection strings, then I can rebuild it. And now we don't have that column encryption enabled. And let's see how that looks. So we'll look up Hunter again, give it a search. And we're able to get data, but it's a byte array.
Right, so we're at least seeing rows, but we're still not seeing zip codes.
Right, and so and that's going to be the case if we look at it. This is, you know, by design. If you don't have the key, then what you're going to see is the encrypted version of
right.
the zip
you're
code.
Protecting the personally identifiable data.
Correct.
Sensitive data in the table.
So what we're needing to do in this application is to switch over from system.data.sqlclient to Microsoft.data.sqlclient so that the .NET Core version will have this functionality. So I'm going to switch back to our other connection string here and then walk you through the process. So up here first, I'm going to go to my Manage NuGet Packages, go over here to Browse and type in Microsoft.data.sqlclient. Make sure you've included pre-release in this case.
Right.
and then hit Install. Give that just a second to install that. And we'll hit OK, Accept.
Sign your life away.
Sign my life away. And now I've got that installed. And then for the .NET Core, we also need to do the same thing. So I'm going to NuGet Packages. Again. Install. Okay. Accept. And now they're it's installed for both. Then when I go back over to this main window.xaml, we see system.data.sqlclient. I'm going to change that to Microsoft.data.sqlclient. And that is, in fact, it.
So you weren't kidding. It's just that one line change.
That one line change. Because all of these other things, SQL connection, et cetera, I might have fully qualified them, but in this case I didn't. And it isn't that common that someone might do so. If you did need to do so, you could do a search replace.
Okay.
And now I'm going to let's do a quick build solution. Get that package in there. And now I'm going to run that .NET Core version again. For instance. Once again with Hunter. Search. Moment of truth. And now we have the owner zip code.
Got
so
it.
It's now handling the encryption in the .NET Core version as well.
Okay.
So this is true for other features as well that you would see light up. Like I mentioned, UTF-8 support data classification, and more features moving forward will be lit up through this package versus SQL client.
Awesome. So we've got a blog post that we'll put in the show notes.
Mm-hmm.
You shared the GitHub repo,
mm-hmm.
and you mentioned that by the time someone's watching this, it'll either be in general availability mm-hmm. or should be fairly close to that.
Yeah, so it's going to be coming into general availability pretty quickly, and it'll be the code will be showing up on GitHub very quickly as well. So we're moving fast.
All right, sounds great. Well, that is the new SQL client that you have. Notice that we've taken a lot of effort to make it as easy as possible for you to be able to convert over and use that new client as she demonstrated for us today. We've got a link for you to visit so that you can learn more about this and get started with your own projects. That's aka.ms/SQLClient, SQL client, no spaces. That'll take you directly where you want to go. Thank you so much mm-hmm. for sharing the client with us and for your time today.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.